Your skin color is a survival story written in sunlight, bones, and blood. But it's not the one you've been told. What you're about to learn isn't just evolution. It's a story of extinction, conquest, and the brutal twist of fate that reshaped the face of humanity. A story that explains why you look the way you do, and why none of us are who we think we are. Chapter 1. The African Cradle, where darkness ruled. For nearly 200,000 years, equatorial Africa baked under ultraviolet radiation so intense, unprotected skin would blister in minutes. This wasn't just sunlight. It was an invisible killer, capable of stripping away DNA, sterilizing populations, and destroying lives before they began. So nature built a shield, melanin, but not just any melanin. In Africa, it evolved into super melanosomes, dense, powerful, microscopic fortresses that scattered UV light, turned it into harmless heat, and repaired DNA 8 times faster than lighter skin can. These weren't cosmetic features, they were biochemical survival tools. 6 core genes choreographed this biological armor. MC1R acts as the master switch, a regulator of pigmentation that stayed nearly unchanged in Africans for over 100,000 years. The result? Uniformity. For over 100 millennia, Homo sapiens displayed remarkably little variation in skin color across the African continent. Nature had found the perfect formula and stuck with it. So effective was this system that for 140,000 years, Africans showed less skin color variation than a modern London family barbecue. One tone, one solution, one evolutionary truth. Melanin meant survival. But this fortress of melanin, perfect under the African sun, would soon become a prison. One that nearly killed us all in the Ice Age. Chapter 2. The Northern Plague. When darkness became a curse. Then came the North. Driven by curiosity, conflict, or climate shifts, humans began migrating out of Africa. They crossed deserts, climbed mountains, and eventually arrived in regions where winter swallowed sunlight for months. Above 40 degrees latitude, UVB radiation, the kind we need to synthesize vitamin D, dropped to near zero. And the consequences were deadly. Excavations in places like Sunghir reveal children with bowed legs, twisted spines, and skull deformities. Classic symptoms of rickets, a disease caused by vitamin D deficiency. Worse still, women couldn't absorb enough calcium for pregnancy, leading to obstructed births and high infant mortality. Evolution's greatest armor, dark skin, had become a biological trap. But nature doesn't quit. It adapts. Slowly, over thousands of years, populations began evolving mutations that reduced melanin production. The first light-skinned humans weren't European. They were survivors. Mutants, in the literal sense, with a genetic advantage in bleak, sunless lands. In Europe, SLC24A5 became the star. One variant of this gene led to a 58% reduction in melanin. In East Asia, SLC45A2 followed a different path to similar results. Arctic peoples adapted in their own way, increasing skin transparency while preserving some melanin to block snow glare. All paths, different directions, but the same destination, lighter skin. These changes didn't happen overnight. Took more than 15,000 years to spread across Europe, but everything changed with the invention of farming. As diets shifted from meat to grains and vitamin D sources dried up, lighter skin became more than an advantage. It became essential. From blazing savannas to frozen death traps, evolution had to rewrite the human blueprint. Fast. Chapter 3. The Yamnaya Genetic Blitzkrieg. Conquest. Written in DNA. 5,000 years ago, the biggest genetic bomb in European history exploded. The Yamnaya, a horse-riding, cattle-herding group from the steppes of modern-day Ukraine and southern Russia, arrived with two things: military superiority and a genetic profile that would rewrite the continent. They brought genes for light skin, light eyes, and lactose tolerance. But more than that, they brought a biological edge honed by survival. Yamnaya herders had endured famines, plagues, and brutal winters. They were able to digest milk, a huge advantage in an age of poor harvests and vitamin D shortages. Their skin produced more D with less sunlight. Their children lived longer, and they didn't just mix in, they wiped out. In some areas, over 90% of the local male lineage vanished within three generations. It wasn't just conquest by sword, it was conquest by reproduction. The Yamnaya took 10 wives for every local man. Within centuries, their genes dominated the population. The impact was staggering. Lactose tolerance jumped from 5% to 75%. Eye color diversified, hair texture changed. Europe's skin literally turned inside out. This wasn't natural drift. It was a forced reset of the human palate. Today, the average European is about 50% Yamnaya. The original hunter-gatherers? Just 20%. What we now call white is less than 5,000 years old, a remix of ancient genes from three continents. Chapter 4, The Invention of Whiteness. When biology met bigotry. For most of human history, skin tone meant climate, not class. Egyptians painted themselves reddish-brown. Greek philosophers debated the virtues of dark-skinned Ethiopians. Vikings sold pale Celts to darker-skinned Muslims. There was no supremacy, just difference. Then came colonization, and with it, the weaponization of skin color. In the 1600s, European powers needed a simple visual hierarchy. Skin tone became shorthand for worth. In Barbados, enslaved Africans were graded by shade. Jet black sold for 50 silver coins. Octoroons, 1/8 black, went for thousands. Whiteness was now currency. In America, whiteness became law. In 1705, only Anglo-Saxons were considered legally white. By 1790, Germans were reluctantly included. The Irish didn't make the cut until 1840. Italians and Jews were excluded until 1924. Science had nothing to do with it. Power had everything to do with it. The irony? Black Americans carry, on average, 30% European ancestry. Meanwhile, studies show that up to 15% of white Southerners have detectable African DNA, often without knowing it. The color line was always a fiction, enforced not by biology, but by fear. Epilogue. The skin we're in. Your skin is more than just a color. It's a time machine, a living map of your ancestors' battles with sun, shadow, starvation, and survival. Even the palest Scandinavian carries DNA from dark-skinned Africans, Middle Eastern farmers, and steppe warriors. We're not black. We're not white. We're sun-adapted apes, painted by evolution's brush over tens of thousands of years. This isn't about race. It's about history, written in your flesh. So the next time someone talks about pure bloodlines, just smile. There's no such thing. Your skin is proof of one thing. We all survive together. So, who really won the skin color wars? Did light skin save lives or curse us with new vulnerabilities? Was whiteness actually power or just an illusion? Drop your thoughts in the comments. I'll be there responding to the wildest takes. And if this shook your understanding of history, hit that like, subscribe, and share. We're just getting started.